Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. In this episode, let me show you a technique in Numbers that allows you to highlight one cell based on the contents of another. So I was asked this question recently, and I've seen other people have asked it online before. What if you want to set a cell to have conditional highlighting based on what's on other cells? So let me first talk about what conditional highlighting is. Conditional highlighting will change the formatting of a cell based on the contents of the cell. So for instance, I can select this cell here, and if I go to Format Cell, I can hit Conditional Highlighting, Add a Rule, and say something like, if this number is less than 50, then, and I can choose some highlighting things to be here, including custom style. Let's say red fill. And you can see now it is red, but if I were to change this number here to something greater than 50, it's not red. So the value here changes what the formatting looks like. And this helps you see something, a problem or an issue that you need to address inside of your spreadsheet. Like in this case, maybe that inventory is too low. Now, let's say if you want to have that conditional highlighting depend upon what's in another cell. So I have another column here that shows a minimum amount because what's too low for apples in my inventory may be different than for peaches. So each one's got a minimum threshold, and I can change this highlighting here. So instead of less than 50, I can say if it's less than what's in this cell. So I clicked on the little formula button there, and I then selected that cell to set it to minimum apples. And now if it's less than what's in minimum apples. So I can now distribute this. If I select all these cells here and I look under format, and it has conditional highlighting combine rules. So I'm going to combine it. So now the conditional formatting is the same for all of these. So whenever this is less than the one to the right of it, it's going to be red and highlighted. And you can see that's true for here and that's true for here. And that's great, but that's not what people want. What people want, I'm going to clear the highlighting rules here. What people want is they want in a third column here to show something, like maybe a message that says time to reorder, and have that be highlighted based on what's in these two cells. We could do that too. So the first thing is that you can only add conditional highlighting based on the value of the cell itself, not of external cells. This seems contradictory to what I just said, but we can make it work with a formula. You can use an if statement, and here I've got one in there, and I've set it to if the inventory for apples, so this B2 cell, is less than the C2 cell, the minimum for apples, then put the text reorder in the cell. Otherwise, put the text nothing, just blank, into the cell. Now when I copy and paste this, you can see I get the words reorder for the two rows where this applies. So it's just time to add conditional highlighting. I'm going to select all those cells. I'm going to go to Format Cell, Conditional Highlighting, Add a Rule, and switch to if the text is reorder, then go to a red fill. And now you can see that not only is the word there, but because the word is there, the cell now is red and highlighted. So you can actually see this happening dynamically. Like if I would change this value here to an 8, that appears. If I would increase this to a 19, you can see it goes away. So I've successfully put a really good indicator here that allows me to see which items I need to reorder. This could be done for all sorts of things. And the question I was asked, it was you would fill in some medical information, I assume, and then if your blood pressure was too high, a message would appear and it would show in red, just like this reorder message.